It's that time again. A game needs an update. And I'm actually gonna fucking make a legitimate, useless, bland filler video that's gonna go in for about 10 minutes because fuck it, who cares? If anyone enjoys my satirical, sarcastic satire, good for you. Now you're just going to be staring at nothing for 10 minutes. I may or may not continue talking. Who the fuck knows? The answer is both. You know, because I can stop talking at various points and then start talking at other points. Yeah, so fuck you for thinking in the binary as a one-dimensional idiot. I'm multidimensional, you fucking idiot. Two gigabytes. A one there. Listen, you. Stay where I put you and don't fall down again, okay? Don't move. This is probably the update that PC got regarding the changes to status and how it works in game, amongst other things. Oh yeah, including self-damage. Yeah, I forgot about that. Could I interest you in a Stug build in these trying financial times? Yes, I'm well aware. Someone else said that before me. Well, not with the financial part, but the rest of it. So, what was it? Tri-Tip? Yeah, Triboros. I'm going to call him Tri-Tip. Ashisogi Tenno. I'm going to call him Asshat Tenno. Cephalon jizz in your face. Cephalon jizz in your face. What about Makari? Well, Maker's Mark. Fuck it. Who cares? It rhymes. It doesn't fit the idiomatic of the perverse. It breaks from that trend that I said earlier. You know, playing on your bullshit fallacy of the rule of three. Yeah, I got three that were perverse and then I switched. Yeah, go fuck you. Stop being so binary. Or in this case, tritipinary. And of course, Train Boy is Train Boy. Mr. Boobinface. Mr. Boobinface. Quite honestly, I'm glad he got a boobin' rework. I really am. Because now Boobin is more fun to watch being played. Even though I have one myself. I should probably work on getting the Prime.
Wordframe Empyrean. What is new?
Scarlet Spear. Empyrean, welcome. Customize your rail hack. Excalibur something collection. Prime excessiveness. Build notes. Okay. Now we am to I or am in all are 27.2.0 revised update Warframe. Suck on that, Yoda, with your backward speak. I've got inside out speak, motherfucker. Hey, music. Yeah, I know you're supposed to play while the update goes, but yes, shut the fuck up, thank you. Update notes. I'm just gonna read it out loud. Fuck it, why not?
Warframe may feel a little different this update, depending on where you are in your Warframe journey. Some of you are still being taxied all over the solar system like a scrub lord, mind you.
After the word journey and up until just now, yet none of that was actually in the update notes. I just made it up. Come to think of it, I shouldn't be adding that kind of satire and sarcasm right now. You may notice big or small changes. Volume, I'm turning you off. Okay. A player who has not yet completed Rising Tide will find building their railjack a lot easier. A player with an extensive arcane collection will see most arcanes can now achieve rank 5. Fuck yes! Ha ha! Ha ha! Compensating for dangly parts with increased damage capacity. Ha ha! A player... Wait. There's so many sentences that begin with a player. Hold on. Okay, rank 5. And duplicates can no longer be equipped together. Okay. Arcane stacking is gone. I never attempted it because I never farmed the Eidolons to get enough fucking arcanes to attempt it. I'm still working on collecting all the base level fucking mods on the regular star chart, let alone fucking planes. That's how far behind I am. I'm just gonna be honest. Because fuck that. Fuck lying. That's what I mean. Fuck that. Fuck lying. Okay, can no longer be equipped together. A player using the Kuva Brahma will notice self-damage is gone. Okay, why specifically say the Kuva Brahma? Why not just say any explosive weapon? Never mind. A player with multi-shot mods equipped should see some changes in their upgrade menus with the addition of a new multi-shot stat. What? Fuck. I'm gonna have to test that. All players will notice shield gating has been added to the game. Okay, shield gating has been added with this update, not the previous times I was playing. Bad Katana. Bad Katana. Spank me harder. And all enemies have had their health, armor, and shields rebalanced. Okay, here's my thing. If enemies still have the infinite scaling option, don't give them shield gating. In fact, let's back up from that. Players, we don't get any type of scaling that's consistent across the board with everything, do we? So we don't fucking need the enemies to have shield gating. At all! But it would be an interesting difficulty increase, a small extra percentage in the difficulty spike to do high-level missions or certain assassinations now, wouldn't it? You know, like, I don't know, the fucking sergeant? Maybe shield gating will make him a two-shot instead of a one-shot. That's something worth looking into. That's just scratching the surface. Good for you, scratching the surface. You scratch that itch you have. However you play Warframe, it's likely the Warframe Revised update has touched some part of the game for you. Multishot, shield gating, self-damage, which, for the most part, I was just enjoying watching people blow their asses up. I have some degree of spatial awareness. Not saying it's perfect, and it's on all the time, but I have some degree of it. Please take the time to review our update notes to familiarize yourself with the changes, big and small. Multishot. I'm curious about multishot. I'm really curious. Everybody's been going on about self-damage and shield gating. I'm more concerned with multishot. I'm more curious about multishot. You know, because multi-bear. Multi-bear, multi-shot, multi-dipper, multi-mabel, whatever. Warframe always aims to become a better version of itself. That's a straight up fucking lie, and all of you at DE know it. Why the fuck are you gonna lie like that? You're not aiming to become a better version of yourself. You're aiming to become a fucking meme lord and take over the doctor's position and become Dr. Meme instead of Doctor Who, you fuckwits. What you assholes want to do is create a fixed meme in temporal spatial reality within all of continuance that cannot be surpassed. That's what the fuck you want to do. Oh, I'm going to have an aneurysm laughing at that. I'll develop a cerebral hematombidia. I can't fucking word anymore. Better version of itself, my ass. Ember's World on Flames, anyone? DE exclusively? You know, not having a universal vacuum? Anyone? The Stug being a status weapon with a 0.0% status proc? Anyone? Better version of itself, huh? Fucking idiots. Get out of here, you goofy Canadian folks. You're not fooling me with that fucking loony. Go back to your goddamn poutines. Fuck you. You crazy fucking adorable cunts. Get the fuck out of here. Go back to your fucking half pipe. I'm not talking about your snowboarding escapades, you fuck. You know what I'm talking about. Okay, back to reading. back to reading the update notes. Warframe is still about power. And you being a destructive force in the Origin system with hundreds of tools at your disposal. Go forth, Tenno! Oh my god, it just keeps getting better! Warframe is still about power! And you being a destructive force! Are you fucking shitting me? I'm gonna have a cerebral hematoma from this shit. You goofy Canadian fucks, how fucking dare you? Meme lording is for assholes on the internet, not in fucking corporations like you. You're supposed to be the thing we meme on, not the thing that gets the memes made. Stop memeing on the community, DE! Oh my god. I can't stop. It's too stupid. Oh my fucking god in hell.
Okay, just breathe. Just fucking breathe.
My head hurts. I can't fucking read this thing, can I? It's too fucking funny.
Okay. 80 to 90% from Warframe to Tenno was just complete bullshit. But yes, we do have hundreds of tools at our disposal. That's the only truth in that three sentences.
Oh my gosh.
Please use your powerful feedback responsibly. We all lift. No, we fucking don't. You're the one piling the weights on, DE. You're fucking Nefanyo in this shit. You're the one sitting on top of our shoulders riding us, you fucking cunts. You goofy Canadian bastards. Fuck off.
The new war chapters. The Codex Quest chapter entry for the new war has been added for those who have completed the sacrifice quest. As you might be aware, the new war has started. And with Scarlet Spear coming soon, we want players to be properly informed as the new war develops. If you have yet to complete the Chimera Prologue or the Era Quest, head to the New War Codex quest entry to access a shortcut to these quests. Chimera Prologue or the Era Quest. The only quest I don't have started is the one regarding Railjack. So this is going to add, two new quest lines, Scarlet Spear and the New War. So that'll be three that I need to work on. Railjack onboarding changes. The Rising Tide quest gives you your very own Railjack. But the barrier to entry is conclusively with months of stats too high. I mean, you charged thousands of highly rare resource. Kind of like 60,000 cryotic for one of those weapons. Yeah, I'm still working on that. We are releasing a revised series of blueprints in the quest that sees costs reduced between 66% and 75% for Railjack parts. Okay, so that's not an average of everything. That's just saying the bracket of everything was reduced by a minimum of this amount to a maximum of this amount. So each individual item has its own percentage of reduction. Nice. For railjack parts. And building time reduced to 6 hours each. DE? Yeah, timers? Fucking remove them. There are three situations players may find themselves in. Haven't started Rising Tide, and yeah, I'm in that situation. Anyone just beginning will have fully new reduced BP costs. Yeah, hey, DE, speaking about BPs, blueprints, yeah, fucking Plains of Eidolon on Cetus, yeah, bring back the permanent blueprints for shit, you know, like the fucking fishing bait. And, the fucking, shit for, hunting the fucking Kuakas and Kavats and shit. Yeah, bring that the fuck back. Number two, has started Rising Tide. Anyone with any progress at all gets, one times rush repair drone and will transition to new costs on the next stage. Any old costs will be refunded. Number three, Rising Tide completed. Anyone with a completed quest gets two rush repair drones. All cost differences will be refunded. Well, ain't that just the fucking cat's meow? Or the bee's knees? Or the tits, fucking feather, whatever. I don't fucking know. Make some shit up. I don't care. Why? Well, I'm not going to read that. Yep, veterans. Yeah, I'm a fucking veteran. Because I learned the game mechanics faster than people with, you know, that saying that they phallically cling to. It's not an axiom. I will never accept it as an axiom. It's not a truth. Yeah, someone quoted this bullshit statement to me. After 1,000 hours, I know nothing. Well, thank you for substantiating a synonymous way of wording moron. Moron. Someone who is incapable of learning. Noun. Yeah. You're a moron if you spent 1,000 hours and you know nothing. You're a fucking moron. I can learn game mechanics that fucking fast. I'm a real fucking gamer. I am a veteran gamer. I'm an OG fucking gamer. I can learn the game mechanics that fast. Now, there's a difference between learning things and applying the information you have acquired. There's a massive fucking difference. And don't be a little bitch just because I said I can learn it that fast and say, oh, why didn't you apply it that fast? Well, fuck you, bitch. It's called data analysis, you fucking one-dimensional piece of shit. Fuck you. Railjack changes and fixes. That's an extensive bullet point list. Add a new cruise ship in Vale Proxima missions. Exo Skulled cruise ship. It was a variant of the Gokstad, but it has an impenetrable shield. You'll have to get crafty to figure out how to take it down, Tenno. Good for future me to worry about. Actually, I'm pretty insightful when it comes to stocking up resources and shit in this game for future me. Past me did a fucking phenomenal job of making sure I had 13 million credits to spend on things I'm gonna need today. And spoilers, I'm down to 5 million credits now. Added a forge all button to the railjack payload screen in the dry dock. Okay! Forge all. Just remove fucking wait times for the forge for all this shit,
and add the forge all and forge a specific number. And on top of that, DE, your system where in various menus, I forget which button that I pressed. You know, I pressed the button to input a specific number, and it brings up the Xbox keyboard interface, and I type in a number, and it never accepts and inputs that number. I just have to use the bumpers and triggers to manually adjust it, and it's a flipping pain in the goddamn ass, especially in the Simulacrum. I test with the enemy turned on, by the way. If you want to know why, because, you know, you're too lazy to observe, I'll fucking explain it to you, but only for patrons who pay me to do so. If you want to be lazy, pay the price for it. Okay. Avionics screen no longer uses hold to confirm. Good, because hold button to do a fucking thing mechanic is bullshit, and that never should have been put into games to begin with. People need to be aware of their existence. You know, it's called self-awareness. Idiots. Intrinsic screen no longer uses hold to confirm. Good! You should never have put that mechanic into your game. Avionics that are over capacity will now appear as disabled instead of being outright removed. I don't know what that is. I'll find out later. Probably a lot later. In a continued effort to avoid getting downed in railjack situations you can't control... Wait, why is that a single bullet point to itself? It has one of those semicolons after it. 2 seconds of invulnerability will be given when entering a cruise ship via the Arcwing slingshot. 2 seconds of invulnerability will be given when using context actions and the Omni recall. Disabled migrations during railjack level transitioning void tunnel. Don't know what that is. I'll find out later. To avoid putting new host in completely broken states. On those seconds of invulnerability, why the fuck add that when you could have appropriately adjusted how difficult the enemies are for their level? Because I've looked at some YouTubers who have been fucking around with Railjack, and out of everything that I've seen, one point remains consistent. The enemies in Railjack may say they're level something, but they act like they're significantly higher level. And they one-shot you. Seeing someone get one-shot is like, why the fuck is that a thing? There's not enough missions on the star chart with your Arcwing to significantly prepare you for getting one shot in your Arcwing on Railjack, from what I have seen. It just, come on. What the fuck? One-shotting? Letting enemies one-shot us when they're not even above level 100? Come on. DE, get your fucking shit together. Stop being a goofy Canadian bastard. Get your shit together. Yeah, I know marijuana, weed, it's legal there, but you need to separate your professionalism from getting high and making jokes. You need to realize that game mechanics are no fucking place to put a meme, okay? Okay, improved Railjack Grenier fighter variety across all three Proxima regions. I'll find out what that is later. The way the levels were set up on the various Grenier fighters, some of the nodes had level ranges that were too high for all the varieties to appear. The elite varieties on Earth never spawned, for example. So we readjusted the level ranges for various Grineer fighters, Cosma, Gyar, Exo, across all three regions, so that there was a better spread of the different fighter types across the nodes. In other words, the lower level nodes of a region will spawn the basic fighter types, and then as the difficulty of the nodes progresses, the elites are slowly introduced. Well, no fucking shit, that's the way it should have been from the goddamn start, now shouldn't it? Basically, what that entire paragraph just said was, oh, basic enemies are low level, so we spawn them in a low level area and then progressively spawned in the harder shit as the levels went higher. No fucking shit, Sherlock. I just summarized your entire paragraph in one sentence. When a Railjack mission completes, downed / dead players will be revived and all revives will be reset. Nice! Allowing you and your squad to continue on your Railjack journey instead of having to return to the dry dock. That is fucking nice. This fixes staying stuck in the spectator mode. Okay, yeah. Telling us what it fixes. Come on. I fucking know what it fixes. I don't need to be told. That's why I said it's fucking nice. There's way too many notes on this Railjack thing. You know what? I think I've read enough. I'm going to keep scrolling through this. Oh my god, there's a lot of shit they've fixed. Or at least put the code out in an attempt to fix that's just specifically to do with Railjack. You know what this tells me? Railjack was not ready to be released. Not in the goddamn slightest. If you're having to fix this much shit... I mean, some of it says fucking basic fucking core game mechanics are being broken in Railjack. Come on, DE, get your shit together. Don't release another broke-ass fucking update just because your fuckboy fans pressure you. Tell them, quite simply, be patient. We want it to work properly first. Once it works, then you'll get it. Once we've fucking beta tested it ourselves, once we've alpha and beta tested it ourselves, and we've gotten all the bugs we can get out of it fixed that we can fucking find, then we'll release it. That way it reduces the number of bugs and glitches that everyone fucking encounters. That way... everyone listening who's a fanboy piece of shit, who's impatient, who's a one-dimensional piece of garbage, who has no fucking spatial and self-awareness, who doesn't fucking exist in reality, who's just a programmed piece of shit. That way, they can patch other fucking broke-ass mechanics, you fucking idiots. Oh my gosh. Controller changes. This is still Railjack stuff. Kuva Lich changes and fixes. Murmurs from Kuva Lich stabs are shared across the squad. Yeah, I noticed that. I'm not gonna read the Kuvalich stuff. I'm not ready to even start that myself. Armor and damage changes, enemy. Okay. Here's some stuff for armor and damage changes. And before this update, armor, shields, and health on an exponential curve. Yeah, you know what that is? An exponential curve, it looks like a flat line that's starting out. Then it starts tilting up. Then way on down the line, it does a nearly 90 degree shift, but it has a parabolic curve, and then it just goes straight the fuck up. So when people say it looks like a hockey stick, it looks more like a rounded off right angle. That's what it looks like. Not a hockey stick. I don't know where people get their fucking math on a regular linear chart with an exponential curve. I don't know where you get your fucking ideas about it looking like a goddamn hockey stick. It's a fucking right angle that's rounded off. After, armor, shields, and health on an S-curve. S-curve, I'll need to look that up. You know, I can Google that right now so that I know exactly what the fuck I'm reading here. S-curve. Okay. Well, that's fairly fucking simple. So instead of a parabolic curve where it just goes straight the fuck up, well, it's not really a parabolic curve now that I get my math terminology straight myself. It has a parabolic curve in it, but it's a right fucking angle. The fucking exponential curve, it's a right angle, and it goes straight the fuck up. Kind of like the chart they showed for shotguns and status. My thing is, the percentage of status, you know, just apply that percentage to each pellet. And it's doing, well, let's say it's doing 15%. Each pellet is doing 15% of every status type. Every last one of them, together. For each pellet of the shotgun, or each bullet of a rifle, or each second of a beam weapon. Okay? Simple. Let status go above 100%, same as critical. Then, to make mastery rank mean something, every so many levels, give people more mod card slots to work with for all their equipment. Their warframes, their weapons, everything across the board. So that by mastery rank 15, instead of having 8 slots on a weapon, plus the Exilus, you have 12 slots on the weapon, plus the Exilus. Make the configurations, A, B, C, etc., make them formed separately. And for people who've already been forming the living fuck out of them, make them separate, but leave the polarities right where they are. Okay, S-curve. S-curve starts off flat, then it does the hockey stick thing going up. It stays in that line going up for a bit. Then it does another hockey stick curve, and it's legitimately that angle. It's an oblique angle. And then it goes into being somewhat flat again. So this S-curve, that's a good thing. Enemy scaling on an S-curve, that's a good thing. Okay, damage changes. Enemy damage output should still be close to what is... Wait, what? To what is was in the previous live version of the game before the update. That's a typo. What is was? That is a typo. Okay. Somebody was extra high that day when they went into work. But we have made a few changes that will affect how players take damage in game. Damage type changes. Slash now does not bypass shields and instead does damage over time to shields. Slash status still bypasses armor. So magnetic slash will fuck a bitch up. Toxin damage used to apply to armor with 25% bonus. Now it is neutral. For role distinction, toxin bypasses shields but not armor, whereas slash status bypasses armor but not shields. Okay, so, you know, fucking mix them up, match them up. Find out which one will do straight damage to their health and which one will fuck up their ability to even hit you. Basically, that's interesting. That's gonna require a lot of fucking data analysis before I can say anything about it other than that's gonna be fun to fuck around with. That's the only thing I can say about that at this point. Player shields, health, and armor used to be shared with all so-called AI. What? Huh. So they had to all... So they all... So, excuse me, words. So they had all the weaknesses and resistances that their AI counterparts did. So basically, they took one template or one thing and copy and pasted it between the enemies you face in-game, the NPCs, and you. So you were both referencing the same base mechanics for shields, health, and armor. Now, that explains why a lot of people were cheesing the living fuck out of certain endless game modes. That explains why I think Cephalon Jizz in Your Face actually fucking came out and said it, even though everyone knows you have to cheese those fucking missions. In one of his videos, within the last 2 weeks or so. Well, that was when I viewed it, but fuck, I don't know when he posted it. I didn't look at the date. Okay, now players have their own unique shield, health, and armor type classified as Tenno. Bravo! Well done. Jolly good show, dear boy. Jolly good show. These have all weaknesses and resistances neutralized for now. And for now is bracketed. Just emphasize something. You could have put a comma there to separate it instead of a bracket. Or you could have said, for now, the weaknesses and resistances are neutralized. Why put it in brackets? That's just a personal what the fuck. Make no never mind of that. Ignore it, if you will. Player shields now reduce 25% of incoming damage. Player shields now recharge with custom player-only logic. You know what that means? Hmm. That means that I should read the next few sentences because it's particularly and pertinently relevant. Shield recharge delays are based on depleted or partial depleted shields. I'm guessing that means if it's partially depleted, it'll recharge faster. If it's fully depleted, it'll take a little longer. Next sentence is probably going to substantiate that. Partially depleted shields, any amount, is a 1 second recharge delay. That is way too fucking long when you have bullets flying at you at 0.01 seconds. Full depletion is a 4 second recharge. Oh, DE, you done fucked it again. Seriously? 4 fucking seconds? One second is too long. I can see a fully depleted one taking 2 seconds at maximum. But partially? Just put that at half a second. 0.5 seconds, okay? There. That's a blanket solution. Because adding another algorithm to the game's code, just for the fuck's sake of calculating the percentage that the shield is at, and then assigning a numeric value of how many seconds or parts of a second it should wait before recharging, and then comparing that data to what mod you have on that increases the speed at which the shields recharge, that's a major pain in the fucking ass. Just basically, partially depleted, 0.5 seconds. Fully depleted, 2 seconds. Then the calculations for shield recharge with the mods and everything is a fuck ton easier to code, okay? You have to think of this practically, everyone. Not just DE, not just people who know what the fuck I'm talking about in the coding, the game's mechanics, but every fucking body else. Every fucking body. You have to fucking think of this practically. The game can only process so much at one point in time. If you constantly run code through a physical processor, it's going to overheat, which is why they have cooling systems on them. So reducing the amount of processing code that goes through them by being practical and pragmatic about it, like I'm doing with this shield recharge, instead of having this massive thing that calculates percentages of the shield left and how to apply all that shit with the mods, just, you know, a baseline if one then two, if A then B, apply, instead of if and or XNOR, if not, then so. Instead of all that bullshit, just keep it simple, stupid. Oh yeah, DE, you're going to appreciate this. The Canadian YouTuber, AVE, he's the one who said the KISS method that I'm referencing. Even though it's nothing new, he's the one who said it that I appreciate saying it. K-I-S-S. Keep it simple, stupid. Fucking hell. Moving right along with this. These changes to player shields are in addition to the shield gating changes, which you can read about in our shield gating section. Okay, yeah, I fucking know that. This is the fucking build notes. Why tell me these are the build notes in the fucking build notes? Oh dear God, I've channeled my inner Jim Sterling. Armor scaling. Okay, why? I don't need to read the why. We all know the why. Enemies had infinite scaling, players did not. That was the why. Infested damage. We did not want to overlook the infested in our review. Infested are close-range enemies that telegraph most attacks. Correction, DE. 50% of the infested units are close range. The other 50% are ranged. You know those little mutilist MOAs? They'll sit there, float there, shoot at your ass. And even the Chargers, they have a ranged attack. And let's not even fucking forget about the long arm of the goddamn fucking ancients. The long arm of the fucking ancients. That's a ranged attack. You can make a point with actually counting this yourself and seeing how many units actually have range on them as opposed to just close range, that long range, or medium range. You can do the math on that yourself and see if it's more than half, but it is at least a minimum of half of the infested. That's just a straight up lie, DE. Infested are close range enemies? No. They have more than just close range. They're close to medium range, not just close. Just don't lie. I'll call you out on your bullshit just right away. And if one of those attacks hits you, it simply does more damage. Well, no fucking shit, if you're hit with an attack, it does damage. Yes, the floor here is made of floor. Stay agile, stay moving, and the mission is as good as won. No. Proc slash, like a mother bitch, and the mission is fucking won. Infested damage. Come the fuck on, DE. Just stop masturbating all over this shit. I'm not even going to read the why. Increasing the damage that the infested do? Seriously? You know, DE, let's talk about the infested ancients. I'm not a 12-year-old boy at a goddamn Catholic molester convention, okay? I'm tired of having a billion fucking ancients spawn in and use their goddamn grapple on me constantly, okay? I'm not fucking joking about this. It's a serious fucking problem. Every time I go into the infested missions that are higher enough level, especially the game modes that go on indefinitely, eventually it'll be nothing but goddamn fucking ancients using their grapple. Some of them use this fucking grapple when I'm right fucking in front of them! Idiots. Giving the infested more damage. They have enough damage. It's called fucking toxin. It's a proc that their little fuck MOAs give you, and it fucks you over really goddamn quickly. Especially when you don't have any fucking arcanes. Like myself. So giving the infested more damage is a fucking shit idea. You should have nerfed a lot of the ability of the fucking ancients to toss your salad. NPC aimbots, because I'm not using AI. AI is a shortened version of artificial intelligence. Intelligence simply is. It is or it is not. There is no artificiality to it. NPC aimbots. Up until now, in Warframe, the higher the enemy level, the better their accuracy. No fucking shit. I've been one-shotted by some things. High-level enemies would be pinned at the best accuracy they're capable of. Not quite 100, but getting pretty close. Well, anything above 90%, that's pretty damn accurate. Things like your movement and mods would reduce accuracy, but the potential for bad aimbot moments was too high. Yeah, no fucking shit. We have spread this progression across a greater range of NPC now. We're decoupling enemy accuracy from level to reduce the overall aimbot, like behaviors you face at higher levels. Well, that's going to require several minutes worth of playtesting. Especially if the fucking infested ancients can still hit me with that goddamn fucking salad-tossing grapple. I fucking hate that. Shield gating, friend and foe. Friend first. Let's answer. Okay, I just don't want to read your exposition right here. I know it's fucking something that's needed for a lot of other players who aren't me, and who don't know what the fuck shield gating is. You know, I'll fucking summarize it. On you, the player, for shield gating, here's how it works. Instead of taking one shot and dying immediately, that one shot will take all your shields, and then the second shot is going to be the one that's allegedly going to kill you. So instead of getting one shot, you're going to get two shot. However, looking back in these notes to that bit about health, shields, and armor being separated from the enemy pool versus the Tenno pool, so that it's unique and exclusive to the player, I'm betting that those shot mechanics are going to be functioning a lot more different than just one or two shot. I'm betting that your armor is going to take some of the damage off of it, some of the edge off of that damage. Well, that would be nice, wouldn't it? Foe. Alright, enemies, Corpus in particular, also have received a bit of shield gating. They don't need shield gating. might I offer you a nullifier in these really fucked up, why the hell did you give enemy shield gating times? Yeah, it's gonna be interesting to fuck around with Hildren right now. Hildren, shield gating. How will this work? PC players, you already know what the fuck's up, okay? I'm doing this just for the fucking joke of it. Damn, it's hot in here. But with skillful gameplay, you can overcome this. No, DE. You've made a trash mob even more trashier. Now, I don't mean throw away. I mean their mechanics are shit now, because that is bullshit. In addition, 5% of the damage dealt when hitting the shield gate will target enemy health. What, only 5%? So now I need to, you know, fucking increase my damage output by 500% just to fucking one-shot Corpus now? Well, hold up. My higher level intellect has kicked in and said, hey, remember the S-curve. So what about the S-curve? Shield gating and the S-curve of the enemy progression. Maybe that'll balance each other out. Maybe it won't. Everyone will see. Okay. You know what? Okay, in addition, 5% of damage dealt when hitting the shield gate will target enemy health. This allows you to take your Forma-fueled weapons back to low-level enemies and hit them hard instead of hitting the shield gate. DE. Might I introduce you to Fang Prime? You know, this thing that you made that's has a stat that's less than its base part. You know, it, Fang had a stat, and then Fang Prime had that same stat that was lower than the base Fang. Yeah, might I introduce you to your own bullshit, DE? Yeah, I'm going to call you out because I give a fuck. If I didn't give a fuck, I wouldn't say anything. Wouldn't be recording this video. Wouldn't post it. I wouldn't give a fuck. Alright, I'm going to finish off with the rest of this shield gating for enemy mechanics. The goal here is to make shields a mechanic you want to play against with mods, or as elemental, or to bypass with skill headshots. Really? Slash effects will now deal damage over time to shields. Toxin damage remains as is, bypassing shields to directly affect enemy health. Okay, slash and toxin. Well, that might fuck things over, but magnetic toxin slash will definitely fuck things over. Damage from Warframe abilities will ignore the enemy shield gate. Example. If an instance of damage from an ability is greater than the shield value, it will go into health as well. Fuck yeah! Warframe powers ignore shield gating. Fuck yeah! Well done on that particular part of it. Alright, well, that's the end of that. You've stared at empty black screen and listened to me ramble on. What am I going to call this video? Update 27 point yada yada? Why the fuck not? Alright, till next time, fuck right off.